Welcome back to the show.
Jimmy is so happy. I'm so happy to be
I'm
here,
so
brother.
I'm so happy. This is awesome. You know, I love seeing you. How are you? How's the family?
Family is great.
Yeah?
Kids are playing sports. They play flag football, a little bit of soccer. Got a chance to take my youngest to a flag football game with the Chargers. He met, like, all these famous former football players. He met LaDainian Tomlinson.
Oh, look at this.
My son is a running back, and when he knew that LaDainian Tomlinson was there, he got on his knees and he said, "Teach me your ways." I wish I had a shot of that, but it was pretty freaking
That's
awesome.
That's pretty cute.
Yeah, he's adorable.
I also saw that you had a pretty fun meeting yourself.
Yeah, man, I met the Prince of Wales, His Royal Highness, Prince William.
What was that like?
Cool people.
He's cool people.
Totally cool. First of all, let me give it up.
Nervous?
I also met Hannah Waddingham, star of Ted Lasso,
who is fantastic.
A delightful tall drink of water. Absolutely wonderful human being.
She can sing, by the way.
She can blow,
she
bro.
She can sing.
She don't play.
Yeah, exactly.
She can sing.
Yes, she definitely can. I agree.
Hey, that's when they really sang. The Prince was awesome. I was in Singapore. He had an award show called the Earthshot Prize, which is for people who are doing great things for the planet. So we're talking about air pollution, climate change, water pollution, recycling, et cetera. And so he started it 3 years ago, and this is the third one. Hannah and I hosted it together in beautiful Singapore. Gorgeous. Have you been? You've been everywhere. Gorgeous.
Really?
The way that they incorporate nature into their architecture, just friendly, lovely human beings. And the Prince was there, and he was cool. When you meet him, they tell you straight up. They're like, all right, you call him His Royal Highness, Your Royal Highness, or Your Highness, and then after that you can say Sir. So I saw him, and you don't, like, reach your hand out and be like, hey, give me some, duh.
No, you can't.
That would be not right.
No.
So you wait for him to extend his hand, and then you shake him back. But he was so cool, man. I really like him.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Does everyone get, like, nervous? Like, oh, dude, he's like, hey, be careful.
Folks get a little weird. Like, every time that, like, somebody's running around and be like, you know, the Prince is about to come, so everybody stands up. We all stand up and we act pretty naturally, et cetera. And they're like, oh, it was a false alarm. The Prince not coming. Like, oh, here he comes right now. And you're like,
oh. You're like,
what, is he coming or not? And you're like, oh, no big deal. And then you do it like one more time. And then he comes in. You're like, hey, Prince. And you forget, you stick your hand for it. And I'm like, oh, I'm supposed to keep it down.
That's the one rule.
I'm supposed to keep
the
it down.
The one rule the I'm one not supposed rule. To do.
Then you he
do
stick it. His hand out. It was cool.
By the way, I want to talk about your new movie. I saw it. It's great. It's funny.
Thank you.
You're fantastic in it. But also, now actors can talk about their projects.
We can.
We can talk about a project that came, it's out right now on AMC Plus.
Yes, it is.
Biosphere.
Thank you very much for that. It came out like right at the beginning of the strike. It's me and Mark Duplass. We are the last two dudes on Earth as far as we know it and how we sort of like figure out how to survive. It's a comedy, very funny. If you don't have AMC Plus, run out. No, I'm just kidding. You can get it on demand as well, but it's on AMC Plus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And let's talk about American Fiction.
Let's talk about it.
It's been winning a ton of awards, including you won an award for excellence in acting. There's with the letter D right there.
I did.
Award.
I won the D.
Don't say you won the D.
I won.
No.
I mean.
It is a letter D, correct. I'm sorry, but I messed you up. Sorry, I messed you up. It is a letter, it's the Denver Film Festival.
I've never won the D before.
But congratulations.
My first time.
Yeah,
you know how it is.
Yeah.
It was cool.
Yeah, congratulations. But this is.
Thank you.
Yeah, the movie. Sorry about that. The movie doesn't come out. One time in college. That's it. Yeah, yeah.
The movie
doesn't come out for a few more weeks.
Correct.
But there's a photo that is out of you.
Yeah, sure.
And
me.
I was like, yeah. And I saw. I go, and he's jacked.
Oh man.
You're ripped. And I go,
thank you.
I go, maybe that's one scene in the movie. Then I watched the movie. You're like this in the whole movie.
Kinda.
Yeah.
He's free. You know what I'm saying? And he cares about himself. Listen. This is funny because I say this all the time. I waited to have my kids.
Yes.
I was 35, 39. I think my kids deserve to have someone play with them as much as like young dads do. So I try to take care of myself so I can play with these fellas. That's the bottom line.
That's the whole reason you work out. So you just play with your kids.
Yeah.
Can I ask what?
Go.
What is your routine? Because I would love to do this similar routine.
I'm on this Peloton thing right now.
I do that. I do the Peloton.
You do a little Peloton?
Well, I own a Peloton.
You own it. I own Peloton too. They have great classes. I do a little bit of lifting and a little bit of cardio. So I do the lifting first, and then I do the cardio. Never more than an hour, maybe an hour and a half tops. But I try to get in and...
That's how you end up like this?
That's how, it's also diet. It's diet. Nah. Like, honestly, like, you can work your way crazy, but you can't, after a certain age, you cannot out-exercise a bad diet. So you got to kind of just change the food. What you put inside makes a difference.
I love this.
Yeah.
Can we talk about what the film's about?
I would love to talk about what the film's about.
Yeah, this is great. We can.
Do you know?
Yes, of course we can tell.
You want me to tell people?
I would like you to tell.
So it's called American Fiction. It's about my brother in the movie is played by Jeffrey Wright, wonderful actor. Like
I
you
mean,
guys
come
are gonna
on.
See.
He's...
An extraordinary.
That's the real deal right there.
He's the real deal. He plays a character named Monk, and he is a writer. He is a black man who is frustrated by being sort of like pigeonholed into writing black fiction, whatever that means. So he, as a goof, writes something that he considers to sort of be, for lack of a better term, trauma porn, and it gets embraced by like the mainstream audience and sort of, oh, such a powerful voice. This is so strong, you're so brave. And the whole idea behind the movie is that there are more stories from the black community to be told beyond trauma porn.
Yeah,
that's
perfect.
Yeah,
you set it up absolutely perfect.
It's funny.
It's funny.
Very funny.
It's funny. It's poignant and it's funny.
Thank you.
I want to show everyone a clip here. Sterling K. Brown in American Fiction. Take a look.
What do you see in my brother?
He's funny.
Mm-hmm. He's not funny.
No, not ha-ha funny.
No.
Like sad funny.
Okay.
Like a three-legged dog.
I see it now. Like somebody dying on a toilet.
Exactly.
God.
Exactly. Invariably, you go too far.
You think? I don't think I go far enough.
It's becoming hurtful.
Oh. See?
You know, invariably, you go too far.
Yeah.
You got a kiss, man. Look at you. Just by being pathetic. God bless you.
Hey.
That is like a three-legged dog.
That's exactly right. Sterling K. Brown, everybody. American Fiction is in select theaters December 15th and everywhere in January. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around. Come on, bud.